outside University Hall, everybody, here in Charlottesville, Virginia, for the conference opener for both the number 7 of Duke Blue Devils, who have won 9 in a row, and the Virginia Cavaliers, no slouches themselves right now. They have won 5 in a row. Hi, everybody. Dan Shulman and Dan Bonner with you. Dukeville obviously getting most of the attention. They lost so much from last year, but those veterans, led by Chris Carwell right now, really showing the young guys how to play.
Two starters returned from the national runner-up. A lot of coaches would take that, and Chris Carwell really has been one of the big keys for Duke. He stepped from a supporting role into the role of leading scorer and leading rebounder. He can get it done inside and out, but Duke relies heavily on freshmen. Jason Williams running the fast break. Carlos Boozer finishing it off. Those guys have played well.
Mike Krzyzewski told us this morning that just because the whole country expects Duke to win every game doesn't mean his young players should expect to win every game. They're going to be tested. They already have been tested, and they will continue to be tested in perhaps the best conference in the country. Time now for the Pontiac Sunfire starting lineups. We begin with the visiting Blue Devils, and as Dan mentioned, they rely on freshman Williams at the point, and Carlos Boozer out of Alaska, who has really given them an inside presence over the last 4 games, averaging better than 20 points per game over that stretch. For Virginia, Pete Gillen's got a lot of bodies. We'll see 10, maybe 11 guys tonight, but if you had to pick one guy for the Cavaliers, it's Chris Williams, last year's ACC Rookie of the Year and last week's ACC Player of the Week. Shooting awfully well over the last couple of weeks, Pete Gillen finally has some bodies. He can press, he can run, he can trap, he can play the kind of basketball that he wants to play. Last year, 14-16, and that was good enough for ACC Coach of the Year runner-up, and that's a statement about how few players he had to work with.
Had a lot of walk-ons last year. Mm-hmm. This year, he's hoping for run-ons.
Underway, and Duke controls. Jason Williams at the point.
And Virginia opens in that man-to-man, and they're scrambling around trying to create some pressure situations, and somebody's going to be open, and Nate James drills the 3 to start.
Duke on top early. Virginia's going to try to make it ugly, as Pete Gillen says, and bring it down to their level. Inside feed, and a beauty from a hand to Williams.
Boy, look at Duke get out and run. You can't press somebody who's going to run it down the court that quickly.
And Pete Gillen has maintained, no matter who they play and how good they are, Virginia's going to play their style of basketball. That may be tested here tonight.
Well, if they keep running up and down like this, we're going to get sore necks.
And by Williams, too strong. Offensive rebound and the putback for Williams.
One of the things that Virginia does effectively, when you drive to the basket like that and draw the defense, you can create some offensive rebounding opportunities, and Chris Williams, a fine rebounder.
Carwell on the wing, Travis Watson on him. Carwell's got a quickness advantage. Misses the shot, and Watson, the fine freshman out of Brookneal, Virginia, comes down with a rebound. Donald Hand, a pull-up three.
This could be very interesting. Duke, the leading scoring team in the ACC, and Virginia's number 2.
There's been more scoring in the first minute and 20 seconds sometimes than you'll get in the first 4 or 5 minutes. You'll go to a TV timeout with less scoring than this. And there's a foul on Watson. Virginia out in front early, 7-5, and a fast-paced affair.
Donald Hand, an assist already, a 3-point basket. One of the big keys to this game is going to be his decision-making.
Averages better than 5 assists per game. Williams kicks it inside to Boozer. Now Battier from just beyond the free throw line and buries the jumper.
Dan, that's what you call your classic inside-outside combination. Boozer with a quick spin to the basket, drew the double team, and then he found the open man.
A few weeks ago, Boozer wasn't playing that much, and Duke really didn't have any pure inside players, playing a lot of wing guys. But the Boozer's changed the whole look of the team. And into Watson. Pass is deflected. Now Williams with nowhere to go. Willie Dersh, the lefty, misses the 3 badly, and it's out of bounds to Duke.
Virginia is going to rely on those 3-point baskets. Dersh is a fella who has entered the starting lineup 5 games ago, and the Virginia's winning streak coincides with him being in the lineup.
He's been in double figures in 4 of those 5 games. Williams lost the handle, tapped it to keep it alive, much to the dismay of Gillen. Nate James muscles his way inside, and James has 5.
Well, and I don't know that I've ever seen Pete Gillen that animated about a single particular call. Wow. It's a nervy official over there. Mike Wood.
There's a turnover committed by the Cavs. Turn it back over to Duke. Now Mike Krzyzewski and the Duke Blue Devils, after losing their first two games for the first time in better than 40 years, have really bounced back. They are scoring like crazy. They have topped the century mark already four times this year. Carwell passes up the three and hits a tough two.
One of the reasons that they're playing so well and scoring so well is they're not just taking that first three that's offered. Duke now 5 of 6 from the field.
And already four of their starters have scored. Hall with a travel, says Jimmy Burr on the far side of the court.
And Pete Gillen going for the timeout early.
Virginia was leading 7-5, but the Blue Devils on a quick 6-0 run, and Virginia's turned it over a couple of times. Just 3 minutes and 5 seconds into this game, already Duke 11 and Virginia 7, and again Carwell helping to get it done. A Duke leading. Pete Gillen takes an early timeout to try to calm down the troops a little bit. Blue Devils on a 6-0 run. Williams gets a screen, misses the long jumper, long rebound. Battier's on the floor, and he's got it, only to be tied up by Hand. Good effort on the part of both players.
And that ball's going to go to Virginia. And that's one of those plays, if you're the Virginia Cavaliers and you force Duke into that early three and they miss, you absolutely have to get the rebound. You cannot allow Duke to get on the offensive board.
You know, there were some fantastic games in November and December, but conference play is just a little bit different, isn't it? You can tell when it's a conference game.
One of the reasons for that, Dan, is these teams all know one another so well. Even though the personnel may be different, there's a foul on Jason Williams. Now, this is a tough assignment for Jason Williams because Donald Hand is going to be very aggressive with the basketball. Teams know one another, even if personnel changes, they still get after one another at a high pace.
Williams has it blocked by Battier. He's the club leader in blocks by a wide margin. Williams kicks it into the corner. Carwell the miss, but James the rebound.
And that's a transition rebound right there. Virginia not able to get in place for the defensive rebound, and Duke makes him pay for it with a three.
Battier hits the three. He has come so far in the outside shooting department, shooting 40% from beyond the arc this year. After, as a freshman and even first half of his sophomore year, he hardly even looked for the three-pointer.
Of course, Battier was filling a different role.
14-7, another timeout on the floor. Duke's up by 7. Duke on a 9-0 run right now, leading by 7. For better or for worse, with all the depth Virginia has, Pete Gillen tells us the kind of pace that he wants to play.
When it's fast and it's ugly, it helps us because we have good athletes. I think we have pretty good depth. It's a lot tougher to create that pace. It's a lot easier to slow somebody down than to speed somebody up. But we're going to try to speed up teams.
And Duke, one of the teams that looks like they are more than capable of playing fast basketball. Battier, another block. And then I think James a foul from behind. But Shane Battier has already got 5 points and a couple of blocks in this game.
And one of the things that Virginia's got to do is be able to get the ball inside effectively. And Chris Williams trying to get it. That was actually a pass. He was trying to pass that ball to Travis Watson, who was open. And Watson powers it up and is fouled by Christensen. But they really need to get the ball inside to Travis Watson, who is a freshman who has played very well for Virginia.
6'7", a 250 out of Oak Hill Academy. Pete Gillen says he was the best player on the best high school team in the country last year, and they're more than excited to have him. The Cavs have one of the best recruiting classes in the country. These two schools, actually, have two of the best recruiting classes coming in this year in the entire nation.
Virginia trying to match up in the man-to-man, and this is an interesting lineup in the game for Duke against pressure. Williams is out of there. And I think Chris Williams is going to be called for the foul. The one thing that Duke is going to do constantly, whether the team is pressuring them or not, is to attack. And Battier doing a great job on the inside. A pump fake, and I think the Virginia folks feel like maybe Battier jumped into Williams. But Duke is going to attack you. They get to the free throw line a great deal.
Battier, sure fire from the line, misses the first. Mike Krzyzewski telling us earlier today, if you had to pick one kid in college basketball to put on the NCAA poster and just hold up as an example of everything this sport should be, his pick would be Battier.
Of course, he may be a little less than completely objective about that, but Shane Battier certainly would be one of my top candidates as well.
Hall over James. Long jumper, front rim, and the long rebound to hand.
Again, if you're Virginia, I don't think you can rely on that kind of shot. You like to get it inside, and their hand does on the drive.
Beautiful drive. Donald Hand with five. Changes for Duke. Matt Christensen into the game, and Mike Dunleavy Jr. into the game as well. Another one of the much-heralded freshmen on this Blue Devil team.
Boy, that's a great job by Battier to beat the pressure.
Well, you talked about no Jason Williams on the floor right now, and no true backup point guard for the Blue Devils. James got in trouble and got bailed out. Battier launches again, not this time. Out of bounds to Virginia.
Some great battle on the inside. Pete Gillen's troops really fighting on the board.
Virginia with five consecutive wins, and by an average of better than 20 points per game, they have shot well. They are 9-3 on the season, and there is a ton of optimism that this team may be on the verge of doing some pretty good things. ACC media picked them 7th out of 9. Virginia finished last each of the last 2 years, but do you share the optimism?
I think it's interesting that the expectations are so high as Jason Williams comes back in the game. Last year, Pete Gillen team played with expectations that they were subterranean, but guys like Travis Watson certainly raising the bar a little bit.
Dunleavy handling this time, flies to the basket and lays it in. Up and down they go. 17-12 Duke. And a steal by Dunleavy. And he's all alone for another easy two.
And now Duke with some pressure.
Anything you can do, we can do better. And Pete Gillen forced to use a 30-second timeout. Well, another comment from Mike Krzyzewski this morning, and it's typical of a coach's son, which Mike Dunleavy Jr. obviously is, but poise and intelligence and savvy beyond his years.
I think Mike Krzyzewski gave a pretty good analogy when he was describing Dunleavy. He talked about Dunleavy being in the mold of a Jeff Lamp or Lee Raker, great players here at Virginia.
Dunleavy with a couple of consecutive baskets to extend a Duke's lead back out to 7, forcing Pete Gillen to burn a timeout.
Well, now, Virginia has used 2 timeouts so far, and Virginia is the team trying to create the turnovers. Of course, Duke will take him. Dunleavy just steps in front of the pass. Hand got himself a little too deep that time and did not make a good pass, but Duke has yet to turn the ball over against this Virginia pressure.
A very significant stat. Majestic Map, another freshman, is coming to the game now for Virginia. Knee in hand, both of them can handle the point. There's Watson too strong off the glass. Williams, a great look ahead as Carwell released.
I don't know that anybody can release and get down the court any more quickly than Chris Carwell. He is really a runner out there on the wing, and Jason Williams does a great job finding him.
8 fast break points already for Duke. Roger Mason, a 6'5 freshman from Silver Spring, Maryland, into the game for the first time as well for the Cavs. And here he is taking the pass from Matt and burying the jumper.
Comes in with a reputation as a shooter, missed his first 10 three-point attempts on the year before he finally hit one. That one, of course, a 2. Well, here's Carwell posting up inside against Ham.
Everything but the finish. Rebound to Watson. And another nice look ahead, Chris Williams. It is still Virginia ball. There is no call on the play as Williams was sandwiched.
Well, yes, there is a call, and it was a good block. This is really an aggressive pass by Mapp and a great catch by Chris Williams. You talk about guys who can run, and Williams certainly can. That looked like a pretty good block.
Dunleavy back in a hurry. Dunleavy, by the way, still growing. He's grown 2 inches since he agreed to come to Duke. He's up to 6'8 now.
Duke in the zone defense on the underneath out of bounds play. Virginia has really had a problem against zones this year. No problem there, though.
Mason off the bench hot. He's got 5.
Pete Gillen talked about his depth. That's what you like your guys to come off the bench and do, really give you a spark.
Dunleavy in some difficulty. Finds Boozer. Spins on Watson, too strong. Battier on the glass. Dunleavy has it taken away. Numbers for Virginia. Mapp will pull up.
That is a great defensive play by Jason Williams. Defending the 2-on-1. Make the guy shoot the jump shot.
At the other end, Williams off to Boozer, couldn't handle the pass. Here comes Virginia on the run again. Donald hand on the way. And are they going to count the basket?
It's a charge.
It's
They're
a
not
charge
going to count
on the hand.
Shane Battier may be the best there is at taking the charge. He just measures him, gets down, both feet on the floor, facing the dribbler. Yes, sir. And Donald Hand gets called for the charge.
The National Defensive Player of the Year last year gives us a taste why here tonight.
Reese Davis with you. We promised to keep an eye on Notre Dame and UConn for you at 68-62, just over a minute to go. And Matt Carroll, a little pull-up J right there at 70-62. Buck 15 away from a big upset, Dan.
You are not kidding, Reese. That would be a stunner right in line with the Notre Dame season opening upset at Ohio State. Dunleavy dumps it down and it's Virginia ball. Matt Doherty really has some things happening up in South Bend.
Dan, I'll tell you what, you said it early. Conference play is just something different. It's a different animal, and Notre Dame's showing you that it's in every conference. Boy, both teams shooting the ball very well.
Yes.
Duke at 60%, Virginia at 54.
Former member of the Irish, Keith Friel, transfers.
Oh, what a catch. What a catch. A perfect pass and a dynamite catch inside.
And Chris Williams with an early six. Virginia is back within two. There's Friel guarding Dunleavy. He's a lethal outside shooter. Battier puts it on the floor. Can't get his man in the air. Misses the shot, and Williams has the rebound.
Excellent play by Dondon. Virginia now on a 7-0 run, but Dondon does a nice job not going for the fake.
Stefan Dondon, originally from France, a junior college player, yet another one of the new faces for Pete Gillen this year.
That's a tough place to pick up the dribble.
Williams backing in, has it blocked.
Well, Batty ain't everywhere.
He's on the offensive end, committing the offensive foul.
These guys are getting after one another just a little bit. Battier catches the ball, and Williams just quicker getting to the spot.
Battier sits down, and Nick Horvath is coming to the game. Chris Williams, the reigning ACC Player of the Week, off to a big start tonight. He took the charge and already has 6 points.
Duke's now turned it over a few times. In fact, they're scoreless.
The basket goes Mason. He's got 7 off the bench. It's a 9-0 run to tie the game.
And Duke hadn't scored in 3 minutes.
Looks the way this game's going to go, and that's an eternity. Horvath, wild running hook shot, too strong. And Jason Williams penetrates, dumped over to Boozer, and another turnover. Now there's more basketball coming your way tomorrow over on ESPN2, and again it begins with the ACC number 15 Maryland, led by Terrence Morris, taking on the 9-1 Wolfpack, and then a couple of ranked teams out of the Big Ten, Ohio State and Illinois. It's all on ESPN2 tomorrow night. For more, log on to ESPN.com, part of the Go Network, Go.com.
That's a tough pass. In balanced conferences, those games are critical. Travis Watson steps out of bounds, but NC State and Illinois, they both expect to contend. NC State in the ACC, Illinois in the Big Ten. You've got to get those home games.
Virginia would love to get one here. They have lost 9 in a row to Duke, including all 3 last year, one of them in the ACC tournament, and those 3 losses last year by an average of 43 points per game. Now, granted, Duke, not the quite the juggernaut they were last year, and Virginia vastly improved, and we've got a tie game here. Williams penetrates and hangs and hits.
One thing, this Virginia team, they've got more experience than the Duke team. A lot of young kids in the game right now for Virginia.
And a Williams basket will snap a 9-0 run. The 5 players in the game right now for Virginia, none of them were in the program last year. Dondon strong to the basket, and he is called for the offensive foul.
You roll the dice when you drive to the basket. Now, Pete Gillen is calling his 3rd timeout of the game. He's only got 5.
2-point lead for Duke. He burned one early, just 3 minutes in, and that helped stem the tide for a while. And he has since used 2 30-second timeouts. Again, one of the new rule changes in basketball this year. The timeout system is completely different. Each team gets 5 timeouts. Whoever calls the first, that's automatically a full. And then all the rest become 30s. And Pete Gillen, as you said, you rarely see a coach use 3 of his 5 in the first 11 minutes
of the game. Pete Gillen is very interesting in his use of timeouts. He doesn't try to save him. If he feels like he needs one, he takes one. And that's why that timeout that Donald Hand called to avoid the 5-second violation is a very key thing for Virginia, because that takes one away from Pete Gillen. Of course, in a game like this, if it's going to be a close game, you want to keep possession of the basketball.
Well, you know, an assistant coach over there better be alerted for the timeouts on the Virginia bench. Make sure that it doesn't get away from them. Hot shooting continues for both teams. A turnover on a travel committed by Williams.
Duke didn't turn it over all in the first 9 minutes of the game, and now they've turned it over 5 times. 5 times in the last 4 minutes.
Lost their first 2 games of the year to the Blue Devils. The coaches versus Kansas lost to Stanford and Connecticut. Haven't lost since. They've beaten the likes of Illinois, Ball, Michigan, USC. Now into conference play, where they ran the table last year. Three-pointer for Donald Hand, and Virginia leads.
And that is bad news for the Duke Blue Devils, because when Donald Hand gets hot, he can put up a lot of numbers on that scoreboard.
Averages 14, already has 8. Nearly got the steal from Boozer. Steal. 3-on-1. Majestic map from Hand. Williams penetrates on map. Too strong. Rebound Dondon, and a travel is called as he falls to the floor.
That is by rule. If you have the ball in your possession and fall to the floor, it's a travel.
That's about the only thing that's gone wrong recently for the Cavs. A 14-2 run has given them the lead. Virginia by 3. Neither team relies too heavily on just one player, but what is Virginia doing to get Chris Williams some touches?
Chris Williams does a great job moving without the basketball, and you can see here he's matched up against Jason Williams. Virginia setting some screens, forcing Duke to switch, and you get the taller Williams on the smaller Williams, and they throw the ball right over top.
Three-pointer is good from the wing for Carowell to tie the game, and Carowell's got 7. Both of these teams so balanced and have so many different players who can lead the way offensively. Donald Hand is feeling it. A little bit short on his 3.
Virginia trying to get him some room in that 1-4 set.
Jason Williams tough to stop when he's going full speed, but he missed the shot. And here comes Donald Hand at full speed the other way. He'll pull up from 10. And it's kicked back.
That's Chris Williams. Talked about Chris Carowell running the floor. Well, Chris Williams gets up and down pretty well.
Williams suffered a bad ankle sprain in the preseason. It wasn't himself early. Offensive foul on James as Hand takes the charge.
We mentioned that Duke really likes to attack, and that time the charge was called because James sticks that arm out and knocks Donald Hand down.
Second foul on James. Each team has taken 2 charges already. Another good sign that it's conference play as Mike Dunleavy checks back in for James, who may sit the rest of the half because of the 2 fouls. Hand gets a good screen from Watson. Watson gets the return feed.
Charge number 3 for Virginia. 3 charges taken by Duke. A couple of those by Battier. Watson now with 2 personal fouls.
Battier set a Duke record last year. He took 36 charges. He's already taken 11.
Wow,
here this season.
Boy.
There's the final.
Wow.
That's a stunner. Notre Dame defeats Connecticut on the road. Florida trailing big at Vandy. Look out at conference play for the highly ranked teams. And Duke may find themselves in the same kind of situation if Virginia continues to play as well as they have so far tonight.
That Florida-Vandy game, you talk about, that's a potential upset. But again, Vanderbilt is an extremely difficult place to play.
Williams with a nice feed inside. Carowell couldn't handle it, but it stays with the Blue Devils.
Virginia playing with a lot of confidence, particularly on the defensive end right at the moment.
Just about all of the 5 seconds used up. Carwell finds Dunleavy. Misses the shot. Uncontested offensive rebound.
And Duke's had a couple of those offensive rebounds that they have converted into baskets. Virginia very aggressive on defense, but your defense doesn't end until you have the ball.
Carwell with a 9, averaging just about 17 per game. Here's Mapp, the freshman out of St. Raymond's in the Bronx. Watson draws the double team, tries to split it.
Battier blocks.
Yeah. Boy, that's 3 blocks and a couple of charges taken by Battier already.
And he's hit a 3.
And he's looking for another.
Make up 2.
Wow.
This is a tough atmosphere. Duke got that 14-2 run thrown at him, and Carwell and Battier are the guys who have stepped up for him. That's what you expect your veterans to do.
Battier, the National Player of the Year, his senior year in high school, because of some of his teammates, deferred to them last year and even more so in his freshman year, but taking on more and more of a role in every way possible this year.
Pass.
Williams to Dunleavy. I know you think Jason Williams is one of the best freshman point guards you've seen in a long time.
I'll tell you what, they talk about how he hasn't played much point guard, but if he gets much better, the league is going to really have a problem.
Both teams getting up and down the floor. Duke on a 7-0 run. And got in the air, couldn't get the shot off, and they'll reset with 14 to shoot. Mason's been strong off the bench. The floater won't go. The tip won't go. And the rebound to Boozer.
You're not going to get a floater to go in this game.
By Mason. Williams puts it on the floor. All the way. Boozer threw it away and Williams made him pay. Williams 5 of 7 from the floor, 10 points on the night.
Boozer also didn't get in good position to try to take the charge. Every time somebody's driven to the basket, they're running over folks, but not that time.
Quite a first half here tonight. Duke by 3. Tough one for Dunleavy.
Talked about Dunleavy being 6'8". Donald Hand only about 6'1". Dunleavy used that 7 inches very effectively.
Dunleavy with 8. Donald Hand, the basket and the foul.
And once again, Carlos Boozer does not do a good job moving his feet, getting in position to draw the charge. He hits Donald Hand with the body, but doesn't hit him hard enough. Hand gets it in the goal. Donald Hand is extremely aggressive. He's going to look to drive to the basket. Beats Carwell out on the perimeter. And Battier is also out on the perimeter, so nobody inside to take the charge.
Hand to the line and misses the free throw.
Virginia was the leading free throw shooting team in the ACC last year, but they're only at 65% this year. They've struggled from the line.
Jason Williams for 3, way off.
Ooh.
Dunleavy to the floor hard. Now Williams scrapping with Battier, and Duke gets the loose ball, only to lose it again. Unbelievable. 2-on-1. Hand has it blocked by Carwell.
Is this what they call end-to-end action?
Dunleavy might have gotten away with a walk. Battier hits the baseline jumper. Look out, here come the Cavs. Hand for 3. Not this time.
And Mark Krzyzewski standing up saying, hey, guys, slow down.
I was going to ask you, you're a veteran of this conference. Are they all like this?
No.
This is something else. Near steal by Friel. Now Dunleavy.
Oh.
Everything but the finish. Here's Hand. And he'll slow it down just a notch as well. Williams inside. Gets it to go.
Chris Williams has been as advertised thus far. Has done an outstanding job for Virginia. 6 of 8. And now Mike Krzyzewski gets the timeout. And Pete Gillen's trying to get the crowd into the game.
Look at that. Gillen out on the floor. Telling the crowd, get up on your feet. This is what you've wanted here in Charlottesville. A 3-point lead for the number 7 team in the country, 37-34. Virginia scrapping their way back into it. What intensity there's been here tonight.
Virginia really trying to push the ball up the court. Duke has done a pretty good job in transition defense. And this has been a game, we've still got 3 minutes left to go in the first half, and these teams have really gotten after one another.
Both teams shooting well. Both teams stealing the ball, both teams taking charges. I mean, everything you like to see. A lot of hustle basketball. The high score in the game right now is that fella, Chris Williams, with a dozen.
And you'll notice that Virginia has backed off on the pressure a little bit, mainly because they haven't had time to set anything.
It's been a track meet. Now a little half-court trap. Battier fights his way through it. Again, the crowd wanted a walk. Williams misses, and there is Matt Christiansen for the jam. Back from 3 years of inactivity. Oh, my.
Boy, Adam Hall just kept going up to get that one. Donald Hamm was right in front of us when he threw the ball, and I had no idea to whom he was trying to throw that thing, and then Hands. Boy, put an S on his shirt. Good heavens. Hall just flying in there.
At 6'5", he was up there looking for his first points of the night. He's the only Cavalier to start every game this year, and he misses the free throw.
Very poor free throw shooter, only 45%, and Virginia has missed the front end of the last two 1-and-1s.
2:40 to play, first half, Duke by five. Battier calling for the ball inside and enough contact for a foul to be called on Dondon.
And Battier created that foul simply by working hard. If you're not battling for position in there, you don't force Dondon into the situation where he fouls.
16 points, 6 rebounds, better than 2 steals, takes charges, defensive player of the year, good outside shooter, all-world citizen. What hasn't he turned into in his third year?
He's a fine free throw shooter. Hit 12 of 12 in a recent game against Davidson.
And on the season, 86% from the line.
And he's got a dozen points in this one. Make that 13.
He's now the highest scorer in the game. Duke has stretched it out a little bit. Blue Devils lead by 7. 2:35 to play first half. Duke by 7 late first half. Monday night, we begin Big Monday presented by Bud Light, a triple header. St. John's after an impressive win over Pittsburgh. Monday night on ESPN2, they'll host Georgetown. And then UConn will try to rally from that loss to Notre Dame tonight. No easy one against Chris Mim in Texas. Hano Metala and Utah against San Diego State. For more, log on to ESPN.com. Part of Go Network, Go.com. Duke by 7. Creel's been unable to get open for an outside shot. They're way out on him. Over the double team, shoots Watson. He'll get it back. Now Creel's open. That's his game.
What a bad decision by Travis Watson to take the initial shot, but then great hustle to recover it. Now Virginia with a little half-court pressure.
Battier helping them handle, get it over. Dunleavy can do that as well. Williams from the wing misses the three. Christiansen is fouled.
Christiansen did a nice job on the inside. Chris Williams simply missed the block out. And Duke, not only do they have 14 fast break points, but they've gotten some second chance opportunities against the Virginia pressure. Christiansen now with 4 rebounds. And Chris Williams just didn't do a good job blocking him out. Williams was off balance and fell down and fell out of the play.
Christiansen is a 22-year-old sophomore. We mentioned he's had 3 years of inactivity, spent 2 years on a Mormon mission, and then redshirted last year. So he came to the program in 1995 and 96. He's just a sophomore now.
Doesn't give Duke the athleticism on the inside that a guy like Boozer does, but he's certainly a big body. And as we say, he's got 4 rebounds and now a couple of points.
And it becomes more important because one of the surprises in the summer for Mike Krzyzewski was Chris Burgess leaving, transferring out of the program. They expected to have him back and maybe have Boozer come off the bench and learn behind Burgess.
Talking about Christiansen, and he gets called for the foul, holding against Travis Watson. And another example of a big guy working hard inside. And when you're battling inside on the offensive end, you force that defensive guy to battle against you. And that sometimes that creates fouls.
And Watson will head to the line where he's a 60% shooter on the season.
Virginia has hurt themselves at the line in the first half. They've missed the front end of a couple of 1-and-1s, only 1 for 4. And if you're Pete Gillen, you really you've positioned yourself, your team has, to be in a game like this. You don't want to lose it at the free throw line.
One of two. Some streaks on the line for Duke. They've won 22 consecutive regular season ACC games, 11 of them on the road. Williams explodes by the defense, but loses the ball. Here's Williams. All the way.
As you're counting. Not a great deal else that Mike Dunleavy can do in this situation. Williams simply loses control of the ball, and Adam Hall just takes it right away from him. Now Chris Williams gets going, and Dunleavy simply not into the play fast enough. He has the choice there. He can try to go for the charge or go for the block and just leave him go, and he's just a little late getting there trying for the charge.
Williams with 15 points as Colin Ducharme, the 6'9 junior, checks into the game. Watson will come out. Virginia's right back in it, and so is this crowd. Puts it on the floor, nowhere to go, defended by Williams.
Wait, good movement of the feet by Chris Williams.
Man-to-man for Virginia. Now Jason Williams, 12 to shoot, final minute of play, first half. Clear out for Williams, he'll kick it into the corner. And it is off Williams and out of bounds. Still Duke ball with 5 seconds on the shot clock.
That actually may be an advantage for Duke, because now they get to run a set play with 5 seconds left. Battier was there in the corner with his back to the basket.
I guarantee you something, though, they can't hear each other if they're calling out a set play. Carroll to inbound. Battier does a good job to push off and create some space, but can't hit the shot. Virginia will take over. Heading toward halftime, it's the Courtyard by Marriott Halftime Report with Reese Davis and Jay Billis. Mateen Cleaves is back. The stunner we talked about early, Notre Dame against UConn, and Kentucky and Georgia Tech, the first game of the doubleheader tonight here on ESPN. Friel from the corner. Boy, two Cavs were there. Either one of them probably would have been able to jam it. Instead, they got in each other's way, and then a foul's committed.
Dan, actually, the problem there was that Colin Ducharme and Adam Hall were both trying to jam it. If they just tip that ball, they get a basket.
And Ducharme commits the foul.
Well, what a turnaround that is. You have the opportunity to tip it in for two, and instead you commit the foul, and now Duke has a chance to down and get two on the other end.
At the line, misses the front end. Rebound Ducharme. Shot clock turned off. Virginia can hold it. What a first half it's been.
Well, I wonder if Virginia can hold it this long. They haven't held it this long the entire half.
And up top.
He's got to watch the 5 second call.
Now hand drives, goes by Dunleavy, finds Ducharme. Tie game. Time for Duke. It's Carroll. Has it knocked away. 2 seconds. Friel from half court.
He actually thought that was going in.
In January, and it sounds like they're cutting the nets down here in Charlottesville. The Courtyard by Marriott Halftime Report. Here are Reese and Jay.
It's been a while since they've had anything to celebrate when they played Duke. 43-43 ACC season's here, everybody. And you like the adjustments that both coaches made.
Well, I like the adjustments, especially that Pete Gillen made. One, he took off the press. Duke was doing a great job of shredding the full court pressure that Virginia was putting on. They made it look like a layup drill in the first portion of that first half. And I also like what Pete Gillen did when he called his first timeout. He noticed that Duke was switching that high screen. That left Jason Williams on Chris Williams. That's a mismatch. He put Chris Williams down low and tried to post him. That got Williams involved in the ballgame. And Chris Williams had an outstanding first half for Virginia.
Always finds a way to score some points. Cougs win the courtyard by Marriott. Halftime report rolls on. We've been waiting all season to see this guy, and finally, Mateen Cleaves makes his debut, and we've seen a lot of Troy Murphy. Could he do enough to beat UConn?
ESPN's exclusive presentation of NCAA basketball is brought to you by the Pontiac Sunfire. Hot set of wheels, money left to burn.
A pretty torrid pace sustained by both of these teams through the first 20 minutes. Dan Schulman and Dan Bonner, we're just trying to keep up. As you said, we're going to have sore necks by the end of this one. Mike Krzyzewski knew he was going to get this kind of a game. He talked a lot about the Blue Devils controlling the rebounding aspects of this game and also controlling the basketball. They did better.
They really did do a nice job rebounding the ball, particularly early in the game. They did a nice job on the offensive boards, and that's where they've gotten some points. They've got Chris Carawell on this particular play. The long three-point shot misses, and then Carawell's able to dunk it in. Now, Duke didn't turn it over at all in the first 8 minutes of the half, but turned it over 11 times in the last 12 minutes of the half, and that really helped Virginia get back in the game. And Chris Williams with a big, big first half, 15 points, gets two right there.
And Virginia, with their pressure, forcing an average of 21 turnovers per game, and Duke right about there, turning it over 11 times in the first half. Look at the shooting percentages. How often do you see both teams shoot 50% or better in a half of basketball from three-point range as well? Both teams spread around the offense. Chris Williams with a game-high 15 for the Cavaliers, and Shane Battier, who had a tremendous first half with 13 points to lead the way for Duke. He also had a couple of rebounds and assists, two block shots, and took a couple of charges.
Now, Virginia battled back from being down 9 at 21 to 12 and from being down 7 at 41 to 34. I think it's extremely important to take it off to a good start in the second half.
Battier misses a wide-open look, and the rebound to Dersh, who started but didn't play much in the first half. Hand puts it in another gear and has it swatted out of bounds by Boozer.
Well, they put it in another gear, but you got to watch where you're steering on this particular highway this evening. Hand actually loses his balance, and Boozer says it's right there.
Williams gets a step on Battier, and the defense is forced to come over and help out.
They're actually going to get that foul call, I think, on Jason Williams.
Williams had to come over and help out because Battier got beat by Williams.
Well, Chris Williams, you mentioned at the top of the show, the ACC Player of the Week, and averaging 17 points a game over his last six games. He's got the opportunity to get that average right now.
Number two on Jason Williams puts Chris Williams back to the line.
A couple of foul problems for Duke. Battier's got two, and Boozer has two, and now Jason Williams with two.
And one of two from the line for Williams. Virginia not doing themselves any favors from the line, and Mike Krzyzewski looking pretty concerned here in this ACC opener.
But that's a good screen by Battier. Just a great screen by Battier, and Chris Williams did not really react well to it.
Jason Williams with four, Duke by one. Amazingly enough, this is the 21st time in 47 years that Virginia and Duke have met to open the ACC season. Watson misses the reverse, and Virginia wondering who they anoint to draw Duke first year after year.
Now, Adam Hall called a timeout, but I'll tell you what, if there was a jump ball in that situation, it would have been Virginia's possession, and that's Virginia's fourth timeout. They've only got one left. I tell you what, Dan, I do not think that that's necessarily a good play. The player out on the court calling timeout just to keep possession of the ball. It's not always the right thing to do.
They better be aware now with a better than 19 minutes still to play in this game. Let's go back down to the last possession. You talked about the Battier screen to Free Williams.
You've got to be able to handle the screen. Battier just steps right in. You see Donald Hand knocked off his feet, actually, and Chris Williams has to step out there and force Jason Williams outside, but Chris Williams does not. And interestingly enough, Jason Williams is the one player on the Duke team who has scored in double figures in every game, and he has been held, Jason Williams, that is, to 4 points in this game.
Battier leads the way with 13. 1 point lead for Duke, just underway here in the second half. Here comes Dersh off the screen. Pass inside. We'll turn it back over to the Blue Devils.
And it's interesting, we've only played a little more than a minute, but the game has been a half-court game thus far in the second half.
Which is not what Pete Gillen wants. He wants up and down, and in his own words, make it ugly. trying to take advantage of all that depth that he's got this year. 10 or 11 players he's comfortable with. Battier hangs. Too strong. Ribbon outlet. Good outlet. And Hand again accelerates. Gets in too deep and has it knocked away by Carroll.
With that acceleration by Donald Hand, he knew at half court he was taking it all the way to the basket, and Chris Carroll just did a nice job waiting for him and blocking it out of bounds.
All up top. Dersh unable to get anything going offensively. Guarded by Battier.
Adam Hall hadn't scored in this game for Virginia either. Well, over the last four or five games, he's been pretty important.
Long three for Donald Hand, and he's got 13. He breaks the pressure pretty easily here. Nate James. Now Carroll spins, adjusts, and it's knocked in by James.
Virginia got a block, but Nate James was right where he needed to be, and you create that congestion and frantic pace down on the inside. It's not always easy to block out, and there is foul number three on Jason Williams.
And even though he's a freshman, because he's the only true point guard who gets many minutes, he's a very important player on this team. And now Mike Dunleavy's going to come back in, and so maybe Carroll, maybe Dunleavy, maybe Battier, they'll all share the responsibilities now.
They'll share the responsibilities. This creates some interesting advantages for Duke as well as problems. The problems are they've got to be able to defend against Donald Hand out on the perimeter, but they've got big guys in. They can take Hand down inside.
And right now, Carroll draws the assignment of defending Donald Hand. Hand tries to speed by him. Jump stop. Carroll caught up to him and blocked it. Hand gets it back.
Carroll moves his feet so well, such long arms. That is a bad pass.
Bad decision by Dersh. He gets it back. Shot clock still hasn't reset. It's still at 14.
Shot clock from the corner is good. Another three for Hand.
And Donald Hand celebrates over there with his teammates and the coaching staff. He's now 4 of 6 from behind the line.
16 points for Hand.
Virginia trying to turn up the defensive pressure.
And Hall doing that at the expense of Carroll. Battier wants it in the post.
Hand wants it really badly.
Dunleavy gets Dersh in the air, misses the shot,
and we're going to get a foul. Williams inside. Boy, Battier fighting in there. It's two fouls now on Chris Williams.
Roger Mason's going to come back into the game for Willie Dersh. Mason had a terrific first half off the bench with 7 points. Carroll's again struggling to get it in. It remains Duke ball, but Virginia doing a nice job defending the inbounds play.
Boozer was open for a second, and Chris Williams just flashed over there and knocked it out of bounds. Virginia not covering the inbound passer, and there Chris Williams picks up his third foul.
That's a
tough
one. That's a costly foul potentially for Virginia.
I think Chris Williams had to make a decision, but that's one you don't go after that ball unless you're 100% sure you're going to get the ball.
See if Duke goes at it again. Terrible. Left hand blocked by Watson. Numbers for Virginia. Mason all the way. Scoops it up and in.
Well, now we're back to where we were in the first half. We're going up and down again. And Carroll gets to the basket. This time Virginia over Watson with a really nice play. Now Donald Hand gets the ball to Mason. Dunleavy trying to set up to take the charge, but Mason goes right by him to the other side of the basket. A great decision by Roger Mason to go to the other side of the basket. He's now 4 of 5 with his shooting.
9 on the night. Nate James at the line. That's his 10th point. James with the circus shot of the night to bring Duke back within 2. Prior to that last basket, Virginia's lead of 5 had been their largest lead of the night. Duke has led by as many as 9. Hand thought about it. Now into the corner, Williams. Right by Battier. The floater no good. And Dunleavy does a nice job using his body to grab the rebound.
Oh, nice pass.
Oh, that's pretty. Dunleavy to James to tie the game.
Chris Williams has to be careful driving to the basket. He's got those three fouls in the way. Duke has been lining up to take charges this evening. Williams much too valuable offensively for Virginia to go out with that fourth foul.
Tied yet again. 21 fast break points tonight now for Duke.
Don't average 90 points a game without scoring some in transition.
Hand off to Mason. 12 on the shot clock. Mason by Dunleavy off the glass. And what a confident game Mason is having.
And that's exactly the word for it. Mason just feels like he can get after Dunleavy. Now he's talking to the crowd.
These freshmen aren't playing like freshmen on either side tonight. James with a jumper overhand. Loose ball rebound comes free to who else? Mason. Hand inside. Now Williams.
My goodness, how did he catch that thing? Now again, Virginia has hurt themselves at the free throw line. They're only 4 for 9 on the evening.
Watson will try to improve upon those numbers. Mr. Basketball in the state of Virginia last year. Changes for Duke. Jason Williams back in with his three fouls, and Matt Christensen will come in for Carlos Boozer, who leaves with three fouls. Nate James is out as well.
Christensen had a solid first half for Duke, 4 points, 5 rebounds.
One of two for Watson. Virginia extends the lead to 3. A timeout on the floor. Up and down they go. Fancy stuff and great execution tonight here in Charlottesville. Virginia trying to pull off the upset. A huge week in sports. Sugar Bowl last night. Lots of college hoop all week long. And then Saturday, the NFL playoffs begin on ABC. Buffalo's made a quarterbacking change. Rob Johnson to get the start against Tennessee in the AFC wildcard. And then Detroit, 0 for life in Washington. 0 for 19 in the NFC wildcard game. Saturday afternoon on ABC.
Virginia now trying to exert that pressure.
Jason Williams back in the game. Christensen in the post now for Duke. Dunleavy nowhere to go baseline. Williams for 3.
That shot was blocked.
And Battier misses the putback. Christensen is number 4 on Chris Williams.
Well, I tell you what, that is just a play that you cannot stick your hand in there if you've got 3 personal fouls. You've got to understand how important you are to your team and just let that one go.
Pete Gillen will be forced to make a change, obviously, with probably his best player getting into serious foul trouble here with still 15 minutes to play.
And keep in mind that Chris Williams had 15 points in the first half. And Virginia now going to go with a very small lineup as Majestic Map comes in the game. So you're really looking at a 3-guard set. Adam Hall at 6'5" is going to move down along the inside, but you have 4 guards.
That's
in there.
Right.
You got Hall and Mason and Hand and Map to go along with Travis Watson.
Christensen hits them both. He's been money from the line tonight. 6 points in the game. Duke back within 1.
And this is a lineup, I think if Pete Gillen is going to play, they're really hard going to have to get some turnovers because the rebounding part of it's going to be very difficult for the Cavaliers.
Mason guarded by Dunleavy. And a little bit of an elbow on Dunleavy.
Mason, he has the appearance that he feels like he can just go right by Dunleavy, not intimidated by Dunleavy's credentials one little bit. Another guy who might have to step up here for Virginia is Adam Hall. He has only taken 1 shot tonight, has not scored.
Here's Mason again. The freshman has a season and career high 12 points this year as Watson dumps it off into the corner. And Mason threatening that tonight.
For Virginia, fortunate to keep it that time.
Watson.
Just the guy we were talking about. Again, goes flying to the basket. Offensive rebounds really helped Duke in the first half. Watson, this ball does everything but go in the basket, but Adam Hall doesn't give up on it. Draws the foul from Shane Battier. Nobody blocks him out. Boy, he just comes flying right in. Battier was over trying to double team, and nobody blocked out Adam Hall.
Number three on Battier. Fouls becoming a bigger and a bigger story. And a three-point play the old-fashioned way for Adam Hall.
With Chris Williams on the bench, Virginia's going to have to get some offense from some place, and Adam Hall is as good a place as any.
Trap on Williams, gets out of it. Carroll's got a little breathing room. And there's Battier crashing the glass. Jim Berwan's help, and Reggie Coker says that's Virginia basketball.
Breakaway rim that time was a catapult. Missed the thing and off that went.
A four-point lead for Virginia. 14 minutes to play. Majestic knock. Just too many big fellas underneath.
Oh, what a pass.
Lead pass. Williams to Carroll.
Oh, no.
And he draws the foul.
Good to get.
Donald Hand is charged with the foul. His second. Already each team has committed to five team fouls here in just 6 minutes and 6 seconds of the second half.
Majestic Math took that ball into a huge crowd of Duke players, and if you've got that many guys around you, somebody's got to be open.
Math's got to stop with somebody.
Pass it back out.
Farewell into double figures.
Carroll has been so consistent for the Blue Devils.
Now Mike Krzyzewski is going to go smaller as well. Nate James at 6'6 comes in, and Matt Christensen at 6'10 goes out. So if we thought it was fast before with the big guys in there, look out now. Carroll with 11. And whereas Virginia has struggled from the free throw line, Duke now 10 of 12 from the stripe. Carroll on hand. Hand another three-point attempt. Carroll got a piece. Watson got the rebound.
It's going to be very difficult for Donald Hand to get that shot over Chris Carroll. Carroll at 6 feet six, long arms.
See if Duke tries to go down to Battier in the post.
Or to Carroll down on the inside. He's got a pretty good advantage against Hand in there.
There's Carroll. Misses the jumper. Watson tears it away. Battier's down on the floor again. And the arrow favors Virginia.
Battier going up against Hall and Watson. Well, I don't know how he even got his hands on that ball. He was sandwiched by two guys.
You hate to belabor the point, but all the intangibles that he brings, doing all the underappreciated things in college basketball. How could the freshman
They got the ball all wet. Here, Jim Burr's got to wipe off the ball. This guy's out there perspiring, and now you got to clean off the basketball.
Remember last year, Virginia lost three times to Duke. They lost here by 46, the worst home loss in Virginia history.
Yeah, you didn't have this kind of atmosphere in here last year.
At that point, they had six scholarship players and seven walk-ons. As Watson hits, how times have changed in less than a year. Largest lead of the night for Virginia.
A pensive Mike Krzyzewski. This Virginia crowd, I think, is really helping the home team.
Now, a little of Duke's own medicine.
Yeah, pretty tough atmosphere for this young Duke team.
Boozer has returned. Battier out. Watson again. Too strong. And Boozer has the rebound, and it is crushed by Hall.
Boy, Hall can get off the court, can he?
Number three on Hall. Duke going a bit cold here in the second half. But generally, both teams have shot the ball very well. A missile pass from James missed Dunleavy.
Dunleavy never even saw it. The only guy who did see it was the manager down there, and he didn't catch it.
Yeah.
fans weren't back. They didn't know what kind of an atmosphere they'd have in here tonight. They got a pretty good one.
Well, one of the reasons that they've got this great atmosphere is we talked early in the game about the necessity to get Travis Watson involved. Watson that time picks off the missed shot over Shane Battier and is able to stick it in. Now, the other thing that Watson has done a good job of is he catches the ball. Look how quickly he turns and shoots. With that quick release, Battier doesn't have time to get up and block the shot. You wonder how a guy at 6'7" can play the post? That's how you can play the post. You use your big body to get yourself some room, and then you shoot the ball very quickly.
9 points and 8 rebounds for the freshman out of Oak Hill Academy. Offensive rebounding numbers just about dead even. No field goals for Duke in the last 4 minutes. Jump stop by Hand, hands it off to Hall. Mason making three. That's a new career high for Mason. He's got 14. Williams through traffic. Dunleavy. Great job. Great body control by Mike Dunleavy.
Boy, a nice job by Jason Williams to get the ball through traffic.
That stops a 7-0 run by the Cavs. Hand forces the issue. Carwell recovers. And Hand in some trouble now. Carwell got him again. Hand got it back.
Well, Hand's leading the league right at the moment and had shots blocked. And now the officials are going to discuss whether or not there was the ball hit the rim or there was a change of possession.
Definitely didn't get to the rim.
Well, no, it didn't get to the rim. No. Here he's going to drive the basket. Look how Carwell does such a nice job not committing the foul, staying away. Now Hand's in there. He's thinking about the 3-second violation. So he shoots it again.
And now a timeout's called. Virginia leads by 7, trying to pull off the upset.
And our family.
Roman Dan Bonner back with you here in Charlottesville. 7-point lead, Virginia. After this game, stick around for SportsCenter with Dan Patrick and Stuart Scott. Among the stories, they'll bring to you the return of Mateen Cleaves, the other hoops below, as Utah takes on Charlotte and a championship homecoming for Florida State. We've still got better than 11.5 minutes to go into this one, though, and the Duke Blue Devils are being seriously tested by these upset-minded Cavaliers.
And one of the reasons Jason Williams for Duke really not having a good game, only 4 points, 2-for-9 from the field. Shot clock running down.
Boozer knocked it away. Dunleavy's got it. And oh, what a great
team. Well, he'd like to get Dunleavy out in transition.
4 points for Boozer, but another great feed by Dunleavy. The lead back to 5. Duke now really starting to respect Mason, not giving him any room. Mapp finds the open man. It's Mason. Inside Hall. Now Watson, still 10 on the shot clock. Mapp inside, switches hands, and has it knocked away.
That was excellent defense by Duke. They did a nice job cutting down on the penetration, helping out Virginia. Not really executing very well on that particular sequence.
You tend to forget because of how entertaining this game has been that right now there are 6 freshmen on the floor. Forcing it up and getting it to drop is Carwell.
Again, Carwell with the big height advantage on the inside against Donald Hand. And he has really bothered Donald Hand out on the perimeter with that long reach. Hand with 16 points and 6 rebounds and 5 assists. And Carwell knows how important it is to close out Donald Hand.
A quick 4 points for Duke to get back within 3. Fly to the basket is Mason. A little too ambitious this time, and he's caught behind the play. Here's Dunleavy. Jason Williams can tie it.
And Dunleavy tipped it in. What a tip by Dunleavy. And Pete Gillen just called his last timeout.
With almost 10 minutes to play. A 6-0 run by Duke, making an 8-0 run in the last couple of minutes, keyed by Mike Dunleavy, making all kinds of plays all over the floor.
No,
Dunleavy's plays have been in transition here. He gets the ball down the court. Now, as he flips the ball over, Dunleavy is not going to stand and watch. He takes a step toward the basket. Here he comes flying in there. Nobody blocks him out, and he gets the tip. Duke, we showed you a little earlier, 9 offensive rebounds. They're in double figures now in the offensive rebounding category. And the interesting thing is this comeback has been keyed offensively by the young players, by Dunleavy and by Boozer. Carawell has done a nice job forcing Donald Hand into some tough situations. So Carawell defensively has really done a nice job. But Dunleavy and Boozer scoring most of the points in this Duke run.
Dunleavy now out. Battier back in. Friel has returned for Virginia. Still Virginia ball.
And Chris Williams has now returned for Virginia. Wow. Keep in mind that he's got 4 personal fouls, and we still have almost 10 minutes left to play in this game.
And it gets it into Watson. Duke looks like they've stepped up the defensive intensity. Creel can't get the shot off. 12 to shoot.
See how quickly Carawell got out on him.
Hand.
Did he get that ball over Boozer? Good heavens. Now this time it's Jason Williams matched up against Hand, and he just goes right around him. He climbs up Boozer, uses Boozer for a springboard, and knocks it down. And that's the 4th foul on Boozer.
Wow, this is, the plot is thickening by the possession here tonight, isn't it?
Oh, they're another free throw miss for Virginia. I tell you what, if they end up losing this 6 of 13 from the free throw line, they're not going to have to look any further than that stat.
Hand with 18. Remember, he's a guy who scored 41 last year in a game against NC State. Jason Williams, no. A good strong rebound by Chris Williams.
Now, he's got 4 fouls, and probably he's in more danger on the offensive end than the defensive end.
Double team on Watson. Friel, tough pass into the corner. Friel, now he's open.
Great defense by Duke to force him to step around the flying Nate James and put it on the floor one time.
Williams gets a bit of a moving screen from Battier, but misses the runner.
Watson has really been a force on the boards on the inside for Virginia. He's got 9. Now Boozer goes, nobody finds Watson. And those are the kind of plays that not only keep your team energized, but get the crowd energized. Now again, Boozer's got to be very careful. He's got those 4 fouls, a good catch by Williams, and the tough basket. And it's not only the fans in here who are excited, these players. This is a team that beat them by 46 points in this building last year. You know that the Virginia Cavaliers are enjoying it so far.
The Duke Blue Devils ran the table in the ACC last year and have won 22 straight regular season games in conference going back to 2 seasons ago. Pull-up jumper, no good for James. And a foul underneath, I believe, against Dunleavy.
Somebody knocked Chris Williams down.
Let's go back with some more Duke streaks, even further than that. They've won 35 straight against unranked ACC opponents. They've won 52 straight against unranked opponents overall, and all of those streaks are in jeopardy here tonight.
And one reason, as you just saw, Shane Battier with his 4th personal foul. You know, I'll let you play much as anybody. Stay where you are, guys. Battier with 4, Boozer with 4, Chris Williams for Virginia with 4. It's a good thing these teams have depth.
Virginia's out of timeouts also. Boozer getting a little schooling from Wojo. One of the assistants now in the Duke program. Chris Williams averages 14. It's 1 of 2. He's got 19 tonight. These free throws, though, as you mentioned, they continue to be a 50-50 proposition at best for Virginia tonight. Battier over Watson.
That was good defense by Watson. He just used his body and prevented Battier from getting any closer to the basket.
Watson's got a double-double. Ham. Draws the foul, but at the other end, how about Travis Watson with 13 points and 12 rebounds?
How many times have we seen this? At least twice in the last couple of minutes. Now Shane Battier is going to come to try to block the shot. Battier is matched up against Watson. Nobody blocks out Watson. How do you get 13 points and 12 rebounds in a game? Well, you do it by going right after the basketball. He follows the basketball. If he stands out there, Dan, at the free throw line, he doesn't help anybody.
That's his fourth double-double of the season.
And Adam Hall now gets his fourth personal foul.
So four players with four fouls with better than 7 minutes to play. Two aside, Battier and Boozer for Duke, Williams and Hall for Virginia.
And there's that basket, that bucket there by Carwell, the free throw. An important bucket for Duke.
He hits them both. Carwell with 15, of a Duke trailing by 8. 7-23 to play. Ago, Duke was ranked fourth. They were 18-3, came into University Hall, only to be turned away by 13-6 Virginia. Brian Stith with 23 points, 16 rebounds. Virginia beat Duke by 3. That's a Duke team that went on to the NCAA championship game before losing to UNLV. Your coach and now the AD at Virginia, Terry Holland.
Terry Holland, the coach at Virginia. All-time winningest UVA coach, as you say, now the athletic director here at Virginia. A real gentleman.
I know. There's Travis Watson, that quick release. That time Battier bothered it, though. You know, we talked about Pete Gillen calling that last timeout, but since he called that last timeout, Virginia went on a 9-2 run, make it 9-4. Carwell's now scored 4 in a row.
And Carwell's got 17 to lead the Blue Devils. Chris Williams with a 19 to lead the Cavs. Duke led by as many as 9 in the first half. Virginia by as many as 10 here just recently. Williams had to dump it up.
And Battier makes the pass from flat on his back.
Jason Williams. Dunleavy's wide open, begging for the ball. But instead, it's Nate James.
Well, they didn't have to throw it over there that far. They get a three closer, and suddenly Duke's right back in this thing.
7 points in a heartbeat to make it a three-point game.
And keep in mind that Pete Gillen does not have the timeouts over there. Doesn't have any timeouts left, so he's not going to be able to call one to try to stop the Duke run.
Watson, beautiful feed to Hall. Boy, you have got to love what Travis Watson has brought to the party tonight. And there's a foul on Friel. He does a little bit of everything, doesn't he?
Travis Watson does a nice job recognizing the double team. When you're playing well inside, sometimes you just think, okay, I'm going to turn and shoot it, but he sees the double team come and finds his open teammate, and then Hall, always entertaining when he's around the basket, converts.
That's just Hall's second field goal. That one was fun. The first one was that slam off the missed shot. At the line, James on the season, a 74% shooter. He misses. And the rebound to Hand.
That's only Duke's third miss from the free throw line tonight. They're 12 of 15 now.
They could have sure used those two, however. Virginia walks it up the court. Dunleavy out on Hand. Williams.
Oh.
Watson. No, but the tip is good by Williams.
Boy, Battier, not a guy playing like he's got four fouls. He's stepping in there trying to draw the charge.
21 points for Williams, 6 rebounds as well. Nate James looking for the three again.
Great block out. Tremendous block out by Travis Watson.
And Friel gets pickpocketed by James, and look at Battier. Now Donald Hand. Friel, just not the guy you probably want leading the break. You want him over on the wing. Wait for the pass. So much noise in here. Even if they were trying to tell him that James was coming, he could not have heard. And with a fancy crossover, there's Friel. Wide open. Well, Duke has done a nice job running him, but there's Travis Watson. Now Hall leans in to try and draw the contact. And finally, it's Battier, and down on the floor is Dudley.
Dan, that's a great point that you just make. Adam Hall did lean in to try to draw the contact. I think if he goes straight up, he gets the basket, but in trying to draw the contact, he doesn't convert.
Now Mason returns for Friel. Friel not red hot from outside in this game being played at more of a Mason-like pace tonight.
But Duke has done a nice job running at Friel, forcing him to pass up the first one. Virginia with 14 offensive rebounds, but unfortunately they didn't get a conversion.
Jason Williams, Mike Dunleavy, all the time in the world. Boy. 15 for Dunleavy. It's a two-point game.
Duke stays in that man-to-man. Here's that matchup that's been effective for Duke. Carwell against Hand.
Oh, what a move!
Chris Williams spun Jason Williams just about right out of his uniform. 23 for Chris Williams. Now Jason Williams. What a game!
Jason Williams, that's only his third field goal. He's only 3 of 13, but that was a huge shot.
Well, all the coaches in the ACC felt there'd be a lot more parity in the conference this year. And if this game is any indication, knocked away by James. Hall gets it back. Williams again, double team. Whoa, what a steal by Jason Williams. And here's Carwell, and Hand hammers him, rather than giving up the lead on an uncontested layup.
Hand very fortunate in that situation that Carwell not able to convert it into a three-point play. Hand did get enough contact, however, to prevent that. Dueling huddles
now. That's right. Number 3 on Hand. 1-point lead for Virginia. 3:29 to play. That's a big story right now.
Well, that's a huge story in a one-point game. Carwell going to the line is 4 of 4.
That'll tie it. Duke has rallied back from a 10-point deficit. And now they lead by 1 with a timeout on the floor. It is Duke 81 and Virginia 80. And the Cavaliers find a little more magic in the paint.
ESPN's exclusive presentation of NCAA basketball is brought to you by Courtyard by Marriott, the hotel designed by business travelers.
Three and a half minutes of game action away from SportsCenter here on ESPN. Duke leads by 1. Trying to stave off Virginia. Dan Patrick and Stuart Scott are standing by for SportsCenter with the return of Mateen Cleaves. More coaching news in the NFL. And how about a quarterback controversy heading into the playoffs? Those stories and more coming up on SportsCenter after the game.
Dan, Duke has taken the lead with a 10-2 run in only a minute and 45 seconds. It's a very quick comeback for the Blue Devils. They have 29 fast break points.
Wow. Remember, there are 4 players with 4 fouls. 3 of them are in the game right now. The exception is Boozer. Battier for Duke, Chris Williams and Hall for Virginia. And blows by Dunleavy. Finds Hall. Goaltender made a call.
Boy, that was excellent ball movement by Virginia. Really good decisions out of the perimeter. First by Williams and then by Hand to pass up the 3-point shots.
You know, for a team with so many new players, Virginia looks like they've been playing together a long time.
Since October.
Carwell inside. James with a nice fake. And then he lays it in.
Duke just shreds that Virginia pressure.
Blue Devils have four players with at least 15 points tonight. And a turnover. Jason Williams pulls up just inside the foul line. And the rebound to Mason. Mullen couldn't handle the pass.
Boy, he was looking to shoot the thing, I think, Dan. He's 9 of his last 18 from three-point range, and he saw one there. 16 turnovers now against Virginia.
And now the Blue Devils will take a little air out of the ball with 2:20 to play. Battier looks by Watson for the slam.
Boy, when Watson can post Battier up inside, it's advantage Watson. But when Battier moves him out on the perimeter, Battier just showed you. He can go right by.
Duke by three. And nearing the two-minute mark.
And a big offensive possession for Virginia.
Mason to baseline. All the way.
Boy, he's made some big plays tonight.
16 for Mason.
And remember, Virginia doesn't have any timeouts here.
Crowd energized again. Jason Williams misses the jumper. Virginia's got numbers, but they're going to slow it down. And a fresh 35 on the kick ball.
Very, very difficult evening for Jason Williams. He's missed last couple of shots. He's only made three of them. Three out of 15 now for Jason Williams, and Duke is going to call the timeout.
They're up by one with a minute 33 to play in the ACC opener for both teams.
Battier has the whole side of the court cleared for him, and Travis Watson turned around looking at his teammates and saying, hey, guys, help out here a little bit. But Roger Mason has really played well. Nice left-handed shot after beating Jason Williams out on the perimeter.
Mason, a freshman who doesn't start, has looked like the most confident player in the world in tonight's game.
7 of 9 from the field for Mason.
Mason with 16, Donald Hand with 18, Chris Williams with 23 for Virginia. Dan Patrick and Stuart Scott standing by with SportsCenter with the conclusion of this game. Jason Williams struggling, as Dan mentioned. He's got just 7 tonight. Carowell with 19, Battier and James with 17. So in this first ACC game, it's the veterans, the Blue Devils, who are getting it done.
And why doesn't that surprise anybody?
Less than a minute and a half to play. And now with Dunleavy on. They're trying to clear Watson out of there. Set up a 1-4, let Hand go to work. He drives.
And Travis Watson's going to be called for foul over the back. That was the situation, Duke, with those tall players in the game. Dunleavy moved his feet pretty well. And it's just difficult for Hand to get up over the top.
Number 3 on Watson is also the 10th team foul committed this half by Virginia. So it's 2 shots the rest of the way for Duke. And they've got some guys who can hit their free throws. Dunleavy steps up there, better than 80% on the season.
Well, we've talked about Roger Mason in the game that he has played off the bench. Dunleavy has now scored 16 points off the Duke bench.
But he misses one of the 2 free throws.
Pressure still is on Virginia here, down 2. This is an almost must score as the clock is going to go under a minute before they shoot the ball.
Watson to be guarded by Battier, who's got 4 fouls. Williams, great look. Mason.
Virginia man-to-man.
Dunleavy. And a foul is called up top,
and it is Williams.
Oh, wait, have they changed it? Williams had that who me look on him initially.
Called it on Adam Hall.
And for Hall, that is his 5th.
Nice job by Chris Williams. You see how he draws 4 Duke players down to the baseline, and nobody is out there to get Roger Mason. Some they run at him at the last minute, but Mason
Nice job being on balance and not being bothered, but all the whole defense, four Duke players went down to the baseline. And Adam Hall is now fouled out of the game.
Now the lesser of two evils, I suppose, for Virginia, because had it been Williams, it would have been his fifth. And if Friel's going to come in, the designated shooter.
One of the fascinating things about this game have been the various matchup issues that each team has had to deal with. And for the last couple of possessions, Travis Watson on the defensive end, as Hall leaves, has been matched up against either Battier or Dunleavy, and those guys have done a nice job taking him to the basket.
Virginia out of timeouts. Duke with one left. Dunleavy at the line, shooting two. Rattles home the first to tie the game. Well, folks, get ready. No timeouts. 31 seconds to play.
Now, if he misses it and Virginia gets the ball, what Virginia wants to do in a tie game is hold it for the last shot. If he makes it and Virginia's down one, they're going to take the first good shot they can get, and that's the situation that they're in. You've got to take the first good shot that you can get to give yourself some time in case you miss.
All kinds of offensive weapons on the floor for Virginia, inside and outside. 20 seconds to play. Duke by one. Williams trying to snake his way inside. He did.
And Pete Gillen, with no timeouts, stops the game with a substitution.
Majestic map in for Keith Friel. Take another look.
Chris Williams trying to take Dunleavy, and Battier and Carawell both step in, force him to take that one extra step.
No steal, so a quick foul, and Dunleavy will go back to the line again. And even if Dunleavy hits them both, it's still a one-possession game.
It's still a one-possession game, and Virginia has in the ball game Roger Mason, who's done an outstanding job shooting, and they're going to have Keith Friel come in here very quickly. That foul was against Roger Mason.
Just his first.
It's a two-shot foul, so Friel will have to stay over there until after the first shot. Dunleavy, 3 of 5 from the line. Duke overall on the night, 17 for 21.
And last time down, the Dunleavy did hit a both. Here comes Friel, who once hit 8 threes in a game for Notre Dame against Syracuse.
One of the things you have to do if you're Virginia, you got no shot in this game if you don't block out and get the rebound on the miss.
2-point game.
But now they don't need a three.
Hand. All the way. Got it. Now Jason Williams.
Well, I guess that's appropriate.
That's it. These fans deserve 5 more minutes.
Donald Hand taking the ball all the way to the goal, and Shane Battier, with those 4 personal fouls, does a nice job avoiding the foul. But what a great shot by Hand against pressure. Duke electing not to take the timeout. Jason Williams just wasn't able to control the ball. Coming down the court, though, didn't really get a good shot opportunity. Nice defense by Roger Mason.
Overtime on the way.
Hello, I'm Bill DeWire.
Donald Hand's running layup with 4 seconds left ties it and sends this game to overtime. Tied at 89. In overtime, each team gets an additional timeout. So now Duke has 2, Virginia has 1. The first called timeout will be a full timeout. The others will be 30s.
And you were able to take a look there at Roger Mason coming off the bench. 19 points for the freshman. 8 of 10 from the field. There's another freshman, Dunleavy, who's had an outstanding night.
19 for Dunleavy. Jason Williams, wow, he's had a cold night, but he's not shy. 10 for Williams.
And that's the way you want to start the overtime if you're the Blue Devils. Come out and drill that three.
Rattle Virginia's cage right away. Friel putting it on the floor this time. Finds Watson for the short jumper.
And that's a place where Virginia ought to try to go. Shane Battier matched up against Watson on the inside. Battier's got those four personal fouls. Watson now 15 points, 13 rebounds.
Monster game. Inside, Battier the jam.
Well, he just lost Williams.
At the other end, Watson has it blocked, gets it back. They'll try him again. Through the double team, gets it back the third time, and a push is called on Watson.
Now the push is called on Dunleavy. Oh, no, you're right, it is Watson.
Number four.
Duke doing a really nice job getting down and double teaming against Travis Watson. He was actually trying to throw the ball out to the perimeter, but he didn't do a good job getting it through the arms. There he throws it back out to the perimeter once. Now watch as the ball comes in. He's going to turn, and Nate James does a great job getting over and preventing Watson from getting the pass.
I don't know that that's a push, but it is a foul.
Well,
he just ran him over. Just too much size. I mean, Dunleavy will go flying when a guy Watson's size hits him.
What a good defensive play by Nate James set that whole thing up.
And how about Dunleavy continuing to pile up points at the line? The freshman has 21.
And now Virginia really needs to get something on the offensive end.
Duke led by as many as 9 in the first half. Virginia had a 10-point lead in the second half.
Boy, what a play by Battier. Didn't get away with the ball because he stepped on the line, but stuck his hand in there and knocked it away from Chris Williams. An outstanding pass by Watson to Williams. And Battier saves two right here. Watson on the roll. Great catch, great pass. And look at Battier just take it away.
No basket. Wave it off. Well, I'll tell you, Jim Burr's the most unpopular guy. You're talking about one of the real veteran officials in the NCAA. But waving off that basket and the traveling call on Chris Williams in the final minute of regulation have not been popular calls here, although both appeared to be the correct call.
That ball was definitely coming off. It's not like he tipped one of those that was going in the basket. He just didn't time it properly.
And Chris Williams definitely traveled in the last minute of regulation. And now, that was a foul on hand.
Now Jason Williams really trying to be assertive in the overtime period. A young man who we've mentioned has struggled all night long with his shooting, but hit that big three to start the overtime. Now he's going to get to take a trip to the free throw line.
The foul on hand is his fourth. So Hand, Watson, and Williams all have four right now for Virginia. Battier has played with four for a while for Duke. Jason Williams stepping up when it counts here in the overtime.
77% free throw shooter on the year, and Duke really threatening to blow this one open in the overtime. And remember, we've had one run after another in this game.
One of two for Williams. 6-point lead, Blue Devils. Hand cut off by Carwell. Carwell does a nice job defending smaller, quicker players. Williams, baseline, into the corner to Hand. Off for Williams. And a push is called.
Boy, Duke is doing such a great job flying at the basketball, but then rotating to open players. Mike Krzyzewski's got to be real pleased with this defensive effort here in the overtime thus far.
This is the point that Krzyzewski was making to us this morning, that a lot of people may see Duke on the jersey and expect them to just waltz in here and win this game. And he's trying to impress upon his kids that in spite of 9 consecutive wins and in spite of a number 7 ranking, nothing comes easily in this conference.
You're absolutely right. This is a very young Duke team. A Duke team as yet untested in conference play, but this has been a heck of a test.
Virginia player hits both free throws. Chris Williams has 25. And there's a timeout. Duke's lead is 4 with 3:18 to play in the overtime. The guys wait around a little bit longer to get SportsCenter rolling here tonight, but Dan Patrick and Stuart Scott ready and waiting for the conclusion of this game, which is now in overtime. Dan Schulman, Dan Bonner with you here in Charlottesville, and what a treat it has been to be at this game. It's Duke 97 and Virginia 93 with 3:18 to play in overtime.
Dan, that one of the interesting little stats is that Duke has scored on each of its possessions in the overtime. So Virginia needs to tighten up on the defensive end. Defense! 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 Now Watson out there matched up against Nate James. Duke has done a nice job taking Watson to the basket.
Chris Williams on Battier. Each of those players playing with four fouls. Carroll working down to Mason. Got it.
And again, Duke scores in the overtime.
21 for Carroll, 21 for Dunleavy, 19 for Battier. Balanced scoring, to say the least, for Duke. Chris Williams in the corner. Hand. Now Watson, long jumper. And loose ball rebound to Carroll.
We mentioned Virginia has not had a defensive stop in this overtime period, but they desperately need one right now.
An 8-point lead for Duke here in overtime.
Well, it's hard to lose if you're going to score every time you have the ball.
And Virginia maybe just running out of steam. That pressing and defensive intensity has not been evident here in overtime. Mason flying to the basket. He's got energy at the offensive end.
And Battier just fouled out of the game. Mason, as you mentioned a couple of times, Dan, has played with such confidence tonight. This time he just spins on Dunleavy. Battier not able to get there in time. A circus shot. Boy, what a spin out on the perimeter. Just left Dunleavy looking to see where he went.
So Battier becomes the second player to foul out tonight. Adam Hall already gone for Virginia. Battier had a big night in many departments. Mason has had a huge night. He's 9 of 11 from the floor. Gets the free throw, so he's got 22. And Virginia's got a little life here. Still 2 minutes to play.
But they have to stop Duke. Remember, Duke has scored on every one of their overtime possessions.
And a fresh Carlos Boozer back into the game now, with Battier having fouled out, and Watson's on him out of necessity.
Battier being out of the game makes the matchup for Watson a little easier on the inside, but no easier for Donald Hand, and Duke scores again.
Carroll unstoppable here in overtime. Williams, a two, which is too long, and the rebound to James. And now the clock has become the enemy of the Cavaliers as well. Duke gets it over. And the bench for Virginia screaming. The 10 seconds had already expired.
Well, but see, when you're Virginia in that situation, you're kind of wondering why is it 29-10? And that's not exactly what the officials do.
Carroll back to Boozer.
Six on the kick. For six in overtime are the Duke Blue Devils. They have no turnovers.
Final minute of overtime. Donald Hand. And the rebound run down by Mason. Chris Williams, two more. Huge night for him.
Still a 7-point game. All Duke has to do now is hang on to the basketball.
Pete Gillen wants the foul and finally gets it. Well, a gutty performance for Virginia appears to be all for naught, at least in the win column. Remember, they were trying to snap a 9-game losing streak to Duke. And they had a 10-point lead at 1 point in the second half, but Duke got back into it, took the lead, and Donald Hand actually had to tie to send it to overtime. Travis Watson with a very impressive performance for the Cavaliers.
Donald Hand with a big performance. You know, you can look at about every guy on this court and talk about the impressive performance that he had.
Eight players in this game scored at least 17 points tonight. This guy, Chris Williams, has 27.
But boy, this young Duke team comes in here in an atmosphere that could not be any more hostile. They get down by 10 points, and they still come back and win the game. And Mike Krzyzewski is going to call a timeout.
Again, Duke has scored on every single possession in overtime, and it started just a few seconds into overtime when Jason Williams, of all people, because of how much he'd been struggling tonight, buried a three, and that seemed to set the tone.
And that's a guy that's playing with a lot of confidence, has struggled with his shooting, but has the open three and takes it and nails it.
Dana Patrick, Stuart Scott is standing by for SportsCenter. Among the other college basketball stories tonight, the return of Mateen Cleaves and a very big upset in the Big East.
This is a Virginia program that is in rebuilding mode, and maybe, Dan, the moral victory is enough right at this point for the Cavaliers. You never want to settle for that, but this is a Virginia program that finished ninth in the ACC last year. Progress is incremental, but certainly this is also a Virginia program that lost by 46 points That's here right. at home to Duke last year.
Next for Virginia, Georgia Tech at home. Georgia Tech beat earlier tonight by Kentucky here on ESPN. And next for Duke, they're going to Maryland. Shapes up to be a great year in the ACC. I know you saw Wake Forest and Florida State last night, and Ron Hale single-handedly dismantled the Demon Deacons.
Well, this is one thing I think that's going to be so fascinating about the Atlantic Coast Conference this year is it's very obvious that there is a lot of balance. Everyone suspected that. Florida State picked to finish among the bottom three teams in the league, as well as Virginia. But Florida State gets the win over Wake Forest last night, and Virginia takes Duke to overtime tonight. So it may be a very exciting year in the league. And here you're looking at the ace. Now, these are the overall standings, the team's records going into Atlantic Coast Conference play. A lot of wins there for ACC teams.
And tomorrow night, those top two will have Maryland at NC State on ESPN2. And it figures to be a good game.
And if you're going to contend for the championship in a league that seems to be as well balanced as the Atlantic Coast Conference this year, you better win your games at home.
Majestic Map can't hit the runner. Rebound for Boozer. Steal by Mason. Watson still working hard. And the Blue Devils will basically allow him to lay it in. Just keep spotting.
Are you kidding me? Both teams have more than 100 points. When's the last time you saw that in the college basketball game?
What a game it was for both teams. And listen to the ovation by the fans here, appreciative of the effort that their underdog Cavaliers gave tonight, only to lose in overtime by a score of 109-100 as Duke extends its winning streak to 10. Again, the final score, Duke 109, Virginia 100. For Dan Bonham and our crew, I'm Dan Schulman, and thanks for joining us. SportsCenter with Dan Patrick and Stuart Scott is next. This has been a presentation of ESPN, the worldwide leader in sports. For more, log on to ESPN.com, part of the Go Network, go.com.